The 2-2 Miami Dolphins coming off a really nice 38-16 victory on Thursday Night Football last week against the Ravens are set to take on the 1-3 Cleveland Browns here in Hard Rock Stadium. Let's go first quarter. Dolphins having a nice little drive, and it'll finish with a touchdown from the second-year man out of the Ohio State University, DeKendrick Manning, his fourth receiving touchdown on the campaign. So here's the Cleveland Browns offense, led by fifth-year quarterback Baker Mayfield, as he finds Noah Fant. Fant breaking tackles, a former first-round pick who's been used as a career backup. They've been having a two-tight-end formation a lot with him and David Njoku. Now 3rd-and-8, Mayfield. He's going to show off the wheels as he had wide open room to run, more wide open than a McDonald's drive-thru at 5 o'clock in the morning. Big gain right there. Now, once again, another 3rd-and-8. Mayfield looking deep down the field. He will connect with his receiver, bringing it to the 3-yard line. I believe that's Darius Slayton. And then on 2nd-and-goal, here's Jamal Williams with the score. Jamal will fall in the end zone. He was really solid in this one, the former Green Bay Packer tying up the game at 7 apiece. He returns for Dolphins offense as Tua would be intercepted. You can't spell intercepted without the D. That's Brian Body Calhoun making the play. Cleveland will get the ball back. Let's see if they can put some more points on the board as on 3rd-down. Baker Mayfield looking deep. And Minka Fitzpatrick, more like Minka Fitzmagic, telling Body Calhoun, well, you can do what I can do better. As that's Minka's second interception in as many weeks. And the Dolphins will get the ball right back. There's Jarvis Landry, the intended target. Landry spent 4 years here in Miami. Now 2nd-and-12, Myles Garrett with the sack. What a performance he had. He might be the best defensive player in the NFL now. But Quantavius October would say, well, you can do what I can do better. As he clobbers Baker Mayfield with the sack. So now the Dolphins have it back. 2nd-and-5, Tua sacked again by guess who? The former number one overall pick, Myles Garrett. That's the right tackle, Michael Wilhoit. He's been struggling as he is the backup for Juwan James, who got hurt a couple weeks ago. 3rd-and-17, DJ Moore of a nice catch, but he's just short. And the Browns get it back. And here's Jamal Williams. Open field, nothing but green, and he's going to be untouched like weekend homework for a Cleveland Brown touchdown, and the Browns will take the lead now 14-7. Here returns for Dolphins offense, 3rd-and-7. Tagovailoa, you might as well call him Kim Jong-un because he's launching nukes, but it's tipped and intercepted by the former Ohio State Buckeye Denzel Ward. So the Browns going with a 3 offensive lineman formation here, and it works. Nice 14-yard gain for Jamal Williams, who's over 100 yards. Browns will kick a field goal. Now 10 seconds left in the half. Dolphins hoping they get lucky. But when Myles Garrett is rushing the quarterback, chances are you're not going to get too lucky. Score remains 17-7. 2nd-and-5. Excellent play from the rookie number 69, Quantavius October. 3rd-down. Tua sacked by Garrett. Myles Garrett is the only non-Miami Dolphin to win Defensive Player of the Week this season, and that would hold to form after this one. Garrett did end up winning Defensive Player of the Week, unsurprisingly. There's Carl Lawson with the sack. He's been much quieter than Garrett, who has 10 sacks on the year through 5 games. Here's Jamal Williams getting lit up like a Christmas tree. Dolphins have it back. Here's A.J. Dillon on the screen, and Dillon with a nice gain of about 12. But hold on, flag on the play, and the Zebras are going to call a face mask on Brian Body Calhoun, and the Dolphins will get to move forward. And then on 2nd-and-goal, here's Dillon with his first touchdown of the year. Dillon leads the NFL in rushing yards by a mile. He also leads the NFL in carries, but has not gotten a touchdown until today. 3rd-and-6, big hit from Marlon Humphrey stopping Darius Slayton, and the Dolphins still have life. 3rd-and-1, here's A.J. Dillon. Dillon has a hole, and Dillon will get it to the 25 for a gain of 20. Dillon was really solid in this one like he is pretty much every week. 2nd-and-10, Tagovailoa, he has the moves like Jagger, and he would find DeKendrick Manning for his second touchdown of the day. Manning is one of 4 players with 5 receiving touchdowns this year, which leads the NFL. So the Dolphins now take the lead. Here is the Browns at the 2-minute warning. Nice gain for David Njoku of about 19. fourth and seven. This is likely the game as Mayfield is almost sacked, but he's going to find Jamal Williams, and Williams will keep this game alive, and we got a flag on the play. Face mask on Minka Fitzpatrick, and that will move the ball to the 12-yard line. Now Browns have it at the 2, as the former Heisman Trophy winner Baker Mayfield will get the touchdown. That's Tyler Boyd, and the Browns will take the lead with 109 left to go. Let's see what Tua can say about that. First down, Tua, good start to the drive as he finds DJ Moore, and Moore would gain 25. He was not tackled out of bounds, though, so the clock keeps ticking. Very next play, Tagovailoa, the former national champion, looking deep for Devontae Parker. Parker was very quiet in this game, only 2 catches, but he is 4th in yards. And then with 3 seconds left, here's Ricky Aguayo on to tie, and it's good. We are headed to overtime here in Miami. The Browns called heads on the coin toss. It landed on tails, and the Dolphins chose to kick off. Strange call, but Jamal Williams is stopped, so it looks like it will work. But on 4th down, the field goal is a fake. More fake than my ex-girlfriend, and Desmond King will get the sack. So it looks like the call to kick will actually benefit the Dolphins. 2nd and 10, Tagovailoa, he would find Devontae Parker. Nice catch out of bounds for the former Super Bowl MVP. 4 seconds left, here's Ricky Aguayo for the win, and it's good. Dolphins survive. Nice comeback as they were down by 10 to start the 4th quarter. They win it. 27-24.
Hey, man!